He said something about oversaturation of media being a plague to one's mind, so I thought you might like it.
Hey, beautiful people, another episode, another recap video. So let's talk about Too Short to Ride. In the episode, Steven gives Paradine an iPad to replace her tape recorder, which was replacing her tech enhancements, because I can't wait for how long this is going to last. Amethyst shows up in the short squad, go to Funland. At Funland, the gang is stopped by Mr. Smiley, because he introduces a new height rule, and everyone but Paradine can shapeshift into taller forms, and they get to ride. Paradot's a little bummed until she sees the alien prize, which the group can't win because the game is rigged, and they can only beat it by shapeshifting. Paradot reveals that she isn't having fun because she can't shapeshift. It's a flaw in her own design due to Homeworld running out of resources. Amethyst gives Paradot a really good pep talk, and we learn that Paradot can magneto the shit out of metal objects. That's the episode. Paradot is a running gag machine. Wow Thanks, as well as the aliens, we've seen her interact with both. Wow Thanks is a thing where she learns that's what you respond to when someone says something or does something nice for you. And then the aliens, the Area 51 aliens, it's just kind of a thing that Paradot's always been gravitating toward. They're green, they're small, they're parallel. I think that's awesome. It's just really weird that, like, Paradot just hits every... Like, it seems to be a recurring thing that of every appearance she does, she has these running gags. Versus other characters who seem to be a little bit more relaxed with them. Paradot reminds me a little bit of a high school version of myself. Really dorky, a little over the top, highly dramatic, very into what I'm into. That's a version of myself that I don't really talk to anymore, but TMI. Okay, so here's one of my more dorkier things I used to do, is when I was sitting on the toilet using the number two, I would, by the way, TMI, I would do the next time on, and then narrate my own episodes of TV shows or my own stories. I know I'm the coolest person in the world. Feel free to let me know down in the comments, but you know, like, that's the type of thing that I could see Paradot doing with, like, that camping show. So it's one of those things where it's just, like, Paradot's just really dorky. I think it's awesome. It just reminds me a little bit of a version of myself that I'm not, like, super keen on. That doesn't make me dislike her character. It just makes me really reflect a little too much on my past. I like how Mr. Smiley just stands there as the shapeshifters walk by, and he has his face of, I know who you fuckers are. I know, it's okay. I'm just tired. I haven't slept in days. And speaking of Mr. Smiley, can we talk about how well he's running Funland? I mean, I got the impression that he was the only one working that night, and besides Hellspawn deciding to play with fire, everything's going pretty smoothly for a one-man show. So good job on you, Mr. Smiley. Get some rest. Going back to running gags, we have Catfingers again, yay, and you could probably talk about the shapeshifting thing as being a callback to the birthday episode for Steven, where he shapeshifts to be a little bit taller. So, you know, Steven's got a little bit of his own little callbacks, too. I wouldn't really call them running gags, because they appear so infrequent, but definitely Paradox the running gag machine. And finally, I'm kind of half expecting a lot of people on Tumblr to be overly dramatic with Paradot in the sense of Paradot made Amethyst feel like shit for being an impure quartz. Remember that Amethyst is supposed to be this really big jasper-like gem, and instead we got this little tiny one. And Paradot at the time wasn't intentionally trying to hurt Amethyst's feelings. She was just displaying the facts that she knows about Amethyst's gem. And it hurt Amethyst's feelings. And so it's something interesting that Paradot did not reveal that to Amethyst in that episode. Because that would have been a really good mirror thing. But obviously it works better here. It's just very interesting that Paradot's character was so guarded from revealing too much information from herself that she didn't, you know, divulge that. Because it could have been a simple thing. Oh, don't worry. I can't do half the things you can do because I'm imperfect. And then Amethyst's speech about Paradot worrying about whether or not she, what, like, all of her potential instead of being who she is. It's such a good speech, both for people who have disabilities, but also, I took it a little to heart. I'm going to mention something I haven't mentioned on the channel yet, and I've been kind of scared to, and I've been wanting to do a bigger, better reveal, but for loyalists who are been watching these videos, hey, here's your chance. I've been worrying a lot about me and my imperfections a lot lately, and Amethyst's speech really hit me really well because I'm transgender. My original name was Steven, and then Stevray Bro, and if you notice, a lot of people in the comments section have been calling me Izzy, is because Izzy's my female name. It's the name I've been going by for Close to a month now. I've been living as a woman. You can't tell because my voice is really, really masculine. Turns out that doesn't just flip a switch. I actually had a couple of people who read into it and was just like, "Hey, you sound like a boy. But your Tumblr says you're a woman." And I'm like, "Well, you know, I don't really have a feminine voice, so yeah." But I've been worried a lot about those imperfections, my voice, the fact that I have hair growing on my face after a day of shaving, just a bunch of different stuff like that, and like how I'm not fully female. One of the worst things for me right now is taking off my clothes, and then it's just a boy body. You know, when I wear dresses and have things packaged a certain way, I look very feminine. I look very female, but as soon as you take away the makeup and clothing, it feels like I'm just back to boy. And that's something that, like, it's been really hard for my partner. It's been really hard for my friends to see me struggle with that because, well, it's really hard not to accept what I am right now, and because I'm on this journey of transitioning and I haven't even started hormones yet and stuff like that. And, like, just being really, really excited about the future and what my potentials are and how I want to be those things. But I do, me personally, I was listening to this thing. I was like, okay, you know what? I need to step back. I need to accept the things I am. My friends, my peeps, my boys, my peeps. that's a community reference that no one's going to get. All my boys and all my peeps like to wear nightcaps when I go to sleep. Okay, basically what I'm saying is my friends like me for who I am. I came out to them, all of them accepted and such. But I'm over here like, well, I'm not perfect enough. I'm not what I want to be yet. And, you know, it's, you're in the now, you gotta live in the now. And honestly, if you have a single friend, if you have someone that like messages you, there is a likable quality about you. And, I gotta remember that sometimes, 'cause